Chinese cucumbers.
On one hell of a hot day, and he'd been scouring the close cluttered streets non-stop, forgetting lunch. It's 3 p.m. exactly 1 week after headlines screamed at him from supermarket tabloid, Chinese cucumbers, miracle cure for AIDS. And now, right in the middle of poking around another dusty stall, slapping aside the maggots and fruit flies, he realizes he doesn't even know what the damn things look like. And once he found them, if he ever did, what next? Should he share them with David, forcing the crisp slices into his lover's mouth? Send pieces to their friends, light them like candles, pray over them, offer them a sacrifice, or simply bake them up in a nice casserole. Maybe the cure was just in finding them. Maybe the minute one of the tight-lipped Chinese merchants admitted that he had some of the little babies stashed in the back, David would sit up in his hospital bed and say, "Hey! Didn't do what the newspaper said they did. Maybe they were just like the oils. The oils, those pungent greases it took him almost a year to find. And when he did, he warmed fat drops of it in his hands, rubbed it over David's sunken over the withered up and down the bony legs and between the toes. Then he turned the thin shell over, warmed the oil in his hands again, and massaged David's ass and back and waited and waited and waited and... But the damned oil just glistened under the lamplight. And David just kept on dying, dying so loud you could hear it. He could hear it, but he also heard, new cure on the horizon! Crystals. Yes, crystals. Hung from the neck on pure golden chains. Crystals. Oprah and Phil, Nightline and Current Affairs screaming it! And he heard. He held David's head in his lap and slipped the chain down on toothpick neck. The lavender crystal burning with bad light, glittering against David's breastbone, shaking with his breathing and not working! Not working. But pretty as hell and loud as I am one gorgeous chunk of glass, the crystal screamed. But what is inside this body, I cannot pull out. I cannot silence the clicking and wheezing and purify the rotten blood. But have you tried the oils? Made a near-dead boy in the South End stand up in his bed and scream, hallelujah! But then again, he was also on the spiritual path, repeating to himself 1,000 times a day, I am a good person. My body is pure. I will not die. I am a good person. My body is pure. I will not die. And as he guides David through the words, watching them move, sore and hurting through the mouth, the oil matting his hair, the crystal like fire at his throat, choking on the chant, I am a good person. My body is pure. I will not die. And tomorrow wouldn't be nearly so hot. He'd search all damn day if he had to. And headlines screamed at him from supermarket tabloid, Chinese cucumbers, miracle cure for AIDS. And Jesus Christ, the damn things had to be somewhere.